Hi, I'm Kirsty Meeking from Nao Nails. In this video, I'm going to show you something brand spanking new, and it's super exciting. It's the holographic chrome pigment. So we're going to do it over a few different colours. I've already done one example, so that's what it looks like over the top of Divine Pleasure. So you've got a nude colour. And then I've got one here to show you. And this is over the top of SWAT Team. Those of you that know the colours already, you know that that's black. Jet black, that is. So that's SWAT Team. And this is what it looks like over the top of SWAT Team. So you've got a good example there of what it's like over the top of something really pale and what it's like over a dark colour. Just look at the rainbow there. And now I'm going to show you what it looks like when you put it over the top of green and blue. These colours are, you've got Bayside Kiss, which is your blue. And then we've got Picnic in the Park, which is the green. All I'm going to do is clean over these nails so they're completely clean. I want them to be nice and squeaky clean. No oil on there or anything. The reason I'm showing you over two different colours is because I want to show you what it looks like over the top of a coloured gel polish. And this is how we do it. We're going to use top and base first. So I'm going to do the green first. So I'm going to apply top and base over all of the nails, making sure I cap the edge. You've got to make sure you cover all of that colour. You can't just slap it on and hope for the best. Make sure that you are covering all of the colour, because this product is the one that's going to adhere the holographic chrome powder. If you miss a bit and then you can, if you, so say I just went like this. Oh, we'll just slap it on like that. You can see I've missed the sides, so it would not sit or adhere to that side.
So if you made it, if you did a design,
yes,
in the top and base,
that is exactly what would happen. You could do that, and we will do that. Not today, but on another video.
Cool.
Yeah. I'm going to do exactly the same on the blue, so on this Bayside Kiss, I'm going to do exactly the same. So the next stage is to get a lint-free pad, and I like these ones for doing this technique. These paper lint-free pads. And what you're going to do, with nothing on the pad, it's just a dry pad, you're going to remove the sticky layer. The reason we use a lint-free pad is because if I tried to use cotton wool on this, it would just be covered in little particles of cotton wool, and we don't want that. So we're just dragging off the sticky layer. Next stage, you're going to get your pigment. Just going to tap a little bit into the lid. And we're going to use a makeup sponge applicator, like for your eyeshadows. I'm just going to pop some onto there, and then we're going to start by tapping it over, and then we're going to rub it into the nail. You're not rubbing really hard. You're just gently rubbing over the top, which will sit all the particles nice and flat. Damn, that looks good. That looks really nice over green, doesn't it? Okay, so we're going to continue and do this on all five nails. What I'm going to do now is just take a soft makeup brush with no makeup on and just dust over, just to remove any of the excess pigment. This is just going to help it not to stick in your top coat when you put your top coat on. So we're going to take off the sticky layer on the other hand with the blue one, Bayside Kiss. We're not using any gel residue wipe off solution, just a dry, lint-free pad. So we're going to do exactly the same again. I'm just going to pat it on and then I'm going to rub it in. You need the tiniest amount, you don't need a lot. So you can see that that's taking on a bit of a green colour and that's taking on the blue colour. What I'm going to do now is seal those with the Top and Base from the Urban Graffiti range. You can also use Mega Gloss as well. But the reason I'm going to use the Top and Base from Urban Graffiti is because I'm going to wipe off the sticky layer, which means I'll also clean all the skin at the same time. How clever is that? That makes sense.
Yeah, even I could understand it.
So I'm sealing all of this in. Make sure you go from cuticle right to the tip. If you don't seal any of this when you come to wipe it off, then you will take the pigment off as well, and you don't want that. You want it to look all nice and shiny and sparkly. So again, doing exactly the same on the blue, sealing all that in with the Top and Base. So we're going to use the gel residue wipe off solution and I'm going to wipe over, give it a nice good scrubbing so it's all nice and clean. Can you see how that's just cleaned all that excess off the cuticle as well? That's why I've used this. Going to do the same on all of the nails. So I'm going to finish those off by popping a little bit of cuticle oil on. I'm going to rub that in all around the nail, all around the finger. So that's your green. And let's look at the blue. So you can see that it does shine through, the colour does. So you can put this over the top of any colour that you wanted to. So let's compare them with the black and the nude. Here, there's a little ring for you. What about that? So that's what the holographic looks like over a nude. And then that's what it looks like over black, blue and green. So that's that design finished. Hollow chrome nails. Don't forget to subscribe to this channel by pressing subscribe. Also press the little bell, press that little icon, and that'll give you notifications of when we upload new videos so you won't miss anything. And don't forget to like us on Facebook and Instagram. Like, share. See you next time.
If you were stuck in a desert island, what three things would you take and why?
Class, I like that, that's good. iPhone. I love desert island ones.
iPhone.
A camel for water.
a nail file.
A camel for water?
Yeah, they carry tons of water, don't they? Just stick a straw cactus in the hump.
and a lemon. An iPhone. And a lemon. So I could charge the iPhone from the lemon. Because you can charge phones from citric thing you've got.
Is that true?
Mental.
I'd take a Swiss Army knife. iPhone, Swiss Army knife. I'd find lemon. Would I find a lemon on the, on the, on Desert Island?
And if there's any lemon tree.
Lemon seeds and apple seeds, take them with you so you can eat apples and charge your phone.
Mm.
And sun cream.
Fruit seeds, so I can grow fruit trees and charge my phone. So hopefully there'll be a bit of Wi-Fi knocking about. I can still
plant a Wi-Fi tree.
Yeah. Oh, that'd be good, wouldn't it? Do you think they do Wi-Fi trees?
Well, you'd have to just stand underneath it. It's not very handy, is it?